I'm Kirsty McKean from Naio Nails, and in this video, I'm gonna do some Christmas nails, and we're gonna do some pine cones with a little bit of snow on, make it all festive. So first of all, we're gonna prep the nail. We are going to push back the cuticles and remove any non-living tissue. I hear you asking why, but why do we do that? Well, if you'd watched all my millions of videos, then you would know. And if you haven't, I'll tell you. It's because if we don't remove that non-living tissue, product that we're gonna put on, which is acrylic, will lift. And we don't want that. I'm just gonna remove the surface shine from that nail. I'm gonna give that a wipe over with some gel residue wipe off solution. Just gonna clean it up. I'll get rid of the oil. Don't forget, all the products that we're using today are in the description box below, and you can buy all that online. Just press the link. I'm gonna be using the sculpting form today to extend this nail out. I'm gonna pop the tab on the other side to give it double the strength. Give it a wiggle between my thumbs. And we're going to be doing an almond shaped nail. Once I'm happy that it's straight, I'm gonna close the form. If you wanna see a video that shows you how to create an almond nail, you can also click the link if that's all you wanna see. Now I'm going to dehydrate the nail with the nail prep dehydrator, and then I'm going to use the primer. This is acid free primer, and I'm going to do two coats of that. I'm going to use warm beige and a little bit of clear. I've got high speed liquid in my dampened dish, because I'm gonna work quick. I'm gonna start with clear. I'm gonna pop this at the free edge and build out the length with this bead. I will also just drag that over slightly so I know it's all connected nicely. So I'm just patting and pressing and pulling the product down into shape. And I'm gonna use the warm beige on the nail plate. And I'm going to drag that down over the top. And I'm going to build the rest of the structure with the clear. I'm doing this because there's going to be 3D art on top. You're not really going to see the colour of the nail. However, you will see the colour around the actual natural nail more so. So I want that to have a nice warm colour, so that's why I put warm beige on. So I pop the pinching tool on. What that's going to do is it's going to curve the nail, so it's going to give it more strength. There is a video just about all this shebang, if you want to have a little look.
What's it called?
Nail terminology. It's called nail terminology, there it is. Somewhere there, and we talk about why we do this. So this is going on, it's going to add pressure at the sides, so it's going to force the nail from being this shape to this shape, yeah, which is going to give it a lot more strength, and it'll also look nicer because it'll look nice and slim. If only we could just
do that to ourselves.
Yeah, imagine if we could get a pinching tool and just go. Gonna file this now. Do some nice straight side walls.
Sing your song.
I know, but it's not final yet. I haven't composed it correctly yet. Or even started. Fight it by the side walls, and then we do the cuticle area. Oh yes, we do the cuticle area, and then we do the free edge. Just gonna dust off the excess dust, and then I'm gonna go over with a white block just to buff. Just gonna wipe over with some acetone, which will melt the top surface and make it look even smoother. What I'm gonna do now is apply some mega gloss. It's mega glossy. Nice thin layer, and all the 3D work will be done directly on top. To be honest with you, it's not something that we necessarily really need at the end, but I mean by the end I mean the tip, because it'll be covered in 3D that one. But we definitely need it towards the top. There's no point me just putting a little bit at the top, is there? I'll just put it all over the nail. Slice. So that's all cured now. Why do I always open the lid before I look at the colour's name? Belgian Fountain. We will also need a pinching dowel. So it's like a... It's not like a trumpet, is it?
It's more like a
straw. So if you haven't got one of these, you might be able to use a straw. I'm creating a pine cone. I was going to say acorn, like you said earlier. It's a pine cone. Come off pine trees, they do, don't they? I think. Come on. I'm going to start here. So now you can see the reason that I have chosen this shape, because it's the same shape as the pine cone. Just going to make sure it goes from side to side. I'm making sure it's even. That's only because I know what it's going to be like. So you can see it's got lovely sparkles in. I didn't want to just use like a normal brown. I wanted to do something with a bit of sparkling. And I'm going to cut the shapes of the pine cone into the product. Just using the edge of the pinching dowel. Give it a little wiggle. I'm going to add a little... Is it a stalk? What is it? It's like a little top knot thing. I don't know what to call it. It's like the bit that's attached to the tree.
Top knot.
That gives it life. I don't know.
Is that where boys with top knots come from?
That's,
trees?
That's where they had the idea from, you know. These boys that wear these top knot hairdos, they had it from these acorns. Aura. Are you a strong man? No, any. But I have to use Adam instead. Can't do it, can you? Yeah. He's done it. Yes. Smidge of the old white paint. I was going to put some fur on it to make it fluffy. But when I look at it now, I think, nah. As Adam would say.
Yeah.
Nah. I'm going to dry brush it on. No, we didn't want it completely saturated. We just want a little bit of paint on there. And then we're going to drag up. Just so it looks like there's a bit of snow.
It's beginning to look a lot like a...
Christmas!
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. I'm going to use some matte topical dryly and just brush that over to seal it in. And we'll pop that into the lamp. Just going to use some of the gel residue wipe off solution and I'm going to give that a little bit of a wipe. Just to take off the sticky layer. Now we're going to use a 3D brush. I'm going to put a bead of that down and then I'm going to put a bead of this one down. I'll tell you what colours they are in a second. They are secondary green, this one, and rainforest. I'm going to pull this into a holly leaf shape. Top and bottom first. Just need to set up a little smidge first. While I make this, I'm going to tell you something. So holly, when you look at holly, it's like got them little spiky things, hasn't it? Them little, what we're going to do now, these bits that sort of jump out, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And if you look at holly towards the top of the bush, you will notice that there are less spiky bits. So the ones towards the bottom of the bush are really and spiky. And the ones towards the top, some of them haven't even got any on. You know why that is?
Because things from the bottom eat.
Yes. Yeah. To protect it. To protect itself. Let me tell you who told me that.
Alicia.
Nope.
Cassidy.
Nope. My brother. My 40-year-old brother. He was telling the children at the time. I just, you know, took note on that. I'm going to make a couple of these. Bit of clear acrylic, we're gonna put these on. And I got some corn for popcorn. Then we're gonna put some little berries on. Primary red. Tiny bead. We need some itsy bitsy teeny weeny yellow polka dot bikini.
You're really going to get us done for copyright in this video. There's like 5 songs have been sang in it.
I've got a little bit of brown paint on my palette here. And I'm going to just add a bit of detail into these gorgeous little holly leaves. Got a little bit of yellow, the old yellow paint here, and I'm going to mix a bit of white. I'm just adding a little bit of highlighting with this soft yellow, like lemon.
The acrylic paint.
This is the acrylic paint, yeah. I just want to smudge a bit of it in the middle here, just to add a little bit more depth. I've got a bit of paint on the berry. This is what you can do. Get a bit of paint on something you don't want. If you get some of the acrylic liquid, just brush it over. That'll fetch that off nice for you. Now I'm going to use a little bit of the old white. A little bit, I don't know why I'm talking like a scarce, not a scarce, like a Londoner. A Cockney. I'm talking like a Cockney today. I don't know why. I'm not very good at it. Just a smidge. Just a little smidge. Right, what I'm going to do now is on the berries, we're going to use a little bit of Mega Gloss. We want them shiny. We want them to look juicy and shiny and ready to eat. Don't eat them, because I don't think we're supposed to eat them. I've got a little bit of the Mega Gloss. We're going to drop that onto the berries, and then I'm just going to move it around so it goes all over. That's flooded a little bit, so I'm just going to take that excess off. And we're going to bang that into the lamp a minute. Then I'm going to put some of the matte coat onto the holly leaves. So I'm just going over the holly leaves. This will seal the paint. I'm going to finish that off with some cuticle oil. There we are, that's that one completely finished. So that's how you make a pine cone and some holly leaves and some gorgeous berries. It's something a little bit different for Christmas. You could use that on just a couple of nails if you were doing a full set. It just makes it a little bit more festive for the Christmas time. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Press the button, press the bell, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye! Can you hear those sleigh bells? Ding-a-ling, ding-ding-a-ling. I don't know the words are.
Ding-a-ling-a-loo.
Ling-a-loo.
Don't sing anymore because we'll have to pay rights.
It's a lovely web for sleigh bells to gather with you.
Oh.
I saw the snow is falling and friends are calling you home. There's going to be no right singing it that bad.
Yeah.
Don't you know it's lovely when
you play right together? You never know, somebody might pay you to stop singing.